Size 13. Must be Matt Jack's size.
You've got me, officer. I'll come clean. Now that car, she buff up real good. I painted her dangerous blue. In honor of the dangerous motherfucker that was driving her. Hands on your head, pig. I ain't got time to be playing around with you. Let's just get you out of sight and finish you off.
You're gonna tell me about the man with the blue car.
Go fuck yourself in the ass.
I've no time to lose, Jack. I wanna know who that car belongs to.
Well, what you want don't mean shit to me. I ain't no snitch. You better just lock me up now, boy. Broke my fucking nose, pig!
Next, I'm gonna blow a hole in your face. Spill all of it.
You wouldn't scare me with the CSI. You ain't got it in you. Damn! You out of your motherfucking mind, man?
Oh, shit, Jack. Ain't nothing to it. Just a little bit of self-defense. Page one of the police manual. Kill or be killed.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Stop. Enough. I'm starting to remember some things. You be cool, I'll tell you the tale. Well, I don't know nothing about the guy. He wanted me to get rid of his dirty car, get him a new one with false plates. He paid cash, and I ain't the questioning kind. He said I was supposed to drop the word to a guy named Paco down at the Blue Lagoon when the car was done. Now that's all I know.
We'll continue this discussion down at the station. You're under arrest. You have the right to remain silent. Anything... Anything you say can and will be.
Hey, you look like you got a problem, man.
Oh.
What? They letting you dope heads in the FBI now? God bless America. Now I'm gonna give you a little help with your drug problem, Mr. 5-0. Permanently.
So, you think the origami killer killed Manfred?
That makes sense. Didn't want him spilling his guts to us.
And you suspect Gordy Kramer, right?
Oh, him or one of his men. Gordy has the time and the means, not to mention the fucked up attitude to go along with it. He's only a suspect, but he's a pretty guilty looking one.
Are these your files on the case?
Yeah, I've been working on them for a couple of years. I built up a mountain of paperwork.
Magazines about origami? You think the killer could have subscribed to one of those?
If he was even remotely interested in origami in the last 30 years, his name may be in there somewhere. Trouble is, there's over 500 names. It gets a squat.
I'm starving. Do you have anything to eat?
Well, I'm no chef, but I should be able to make some scrambled eggs if you like.
Great. I'm soaking wet. I need to warm up a little. Is it okay if I take a shower?
I'll be my guest. Go to my bedroom. It's the next door. Oh, I'll cook up the eggs while you're under the shower.
I took the liberty of borrowing your bathrobe.
Looks better on you.
I don't really like raw eggs. Maybe I should have told you.
I'm sorry. I told you, I'm not a great chef.
It's okay.
What's that?
The notebook I took from Manfred's place. According to this, about 30 clients bought spare parts for Royal Machines in the last 10 years. The killer may be one of them.
Oh, you know, checking out the alibi of 30 clients, one by one, that's a lot of legwork.
Except that if we cross-check them with the list of subscribers to origami magazines, you still got that, right?
Yeah, of course. Lauren, wait.
If the killer really used a Royal typewriter, and if he subscribed to an origami magazine, his name should be on both lists.
Well, Lauren, I mean, that's just an assumption, but yeah, I suppose.
His name is here somewhere. Help me, we're gonna find him.
The only guy whose name is on both lists died when he was 10. What are you gonna do now? Dig up his coffin, make sure he's dead?
I know it doesn't make any sense. Unless the killer was only using his name.
But why use the name of a kid who died 30 years ago?
Well, that's what we came to find out. The name is John Shepherd. It should be on a grave around here somewhere.
You never give up, do you? Excuse me, I'm looking for... Well, don't worry about it. I can manage alone.
Excuse me.
Excuse me? I'm looking for the grave of a boy named John Shepherd.
Straight ahead, a little further out.
Thanks.
I'm looking for the grave of a young boy who died about 30 years ago. His name was John Shepherd. You wouldn't know where it is by any chance.
The children's graves are in the next plot.
Thanks.
Hey, Scott, where are you going? John Shepherd's grave must be somewhere around here.
Did anyone ever tell you you shouldn't shout in a cemetery?
Take it easy. The dead don't mind. Is that it? Have you given up?
I was just having a look around, if you don't mind. Thought I found a new partner, not another lieutenant. Hey, Lauren, I found it.
These flowers are fresh. Looks like someone's still tending the grave. Origami figures.
That's one hell of a coincidence.
Oh, youngin', that one I knew well.
You knew John Shepherd?
I've worked this graveyard nearly all my life. I remember what happened. It was in 77, October, I think.
Yeah, good for nothing, hoodlums. Get the hell out of here! God! Beat it, you lousy, no good brats! Come back when your fucking mother comes home from work.
He's drunk again.
What are we gonna do? It's pouring rain. We're gonna get soaked if we spend a day outside.
Well, at least we won't get beat. Little rain never hurt nobody. Come on, let's go play.
Bet you can't catch me!
Thank you.
nothing but a slowpoke. Bet you can't do that. Yippee-ki-yay!
You don't need to do this if it's too hard for you.
No chance, I can do it all right. Just watch. Yeah. Let's play hide and seek. You go and count to 20 and try to find me, okay?
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, 10, 12, 16, 20. Those cries, that's John's voice.
Stuck.
Grab on! I'll put it over there!
Kid never did find any help. And his brother drowned in a pipe full of rainwater.
The boy that lived, what happened to him?
Well, all I know is he got separated from his parents. I think he got adopted. Well, looks like a storm's coming. I guess I better be getting home.
Christ, what a horrible story. John Shepherd drowned in the rain while holding his brother's hand. Do you think he could be the origami killer?
Come on, let's get back in the car.
What's the matter?
That man over there.
Yeah?
It's Charles Kramer.
Gordy's father? What's he doing here?
He's putting flowers on John Shepherd's grave.
tourists ask not to be disturbed.
Time to play the sexy girl.
I would have noticed you before. My name's Paco. Are you?
Madison. I'm Madison.
Well, you move, Madison. You're hot on the ground.
Maybe we can continue this conversation somewhere more private.
Oh, cool, babe. Yeah, come with me.
Thank you.
gun. Get out of there before I get into big trouble. Everything's gonna be all right. Everything is going to be all right.
So, welcome to my little kingdom. I'll take that. Just get in the way of the good things, sweet cheeks. So, show me what you can do. Take it all. Slowly. Take it all off.
Could I have a drink? You know, just a little drink to break the ice.
We already broke the ice. Let's get wet. Come on. Do your thing, girl.
Could we just talk first?
No. We don't need any more talking. I all talked out. Now, show me what you can do.
I'm sorry. I think there's been a little misunderstanding. I'll just go. No harm done. Another time.
I think it is you who have misunderstood. I'm tired of wasting my time. It's now or never. And I never take never for an answer.